Hi, I'm Mark Church, Google Cloud Product Manager, and I'm joined by Chris Shum, Product Lead for MongoDB. I want to talk about how to leverage Private Service Connect for secure and private connectivity to services that's deeply integrated with Google Cloud Load Balancing. PSC provides private and service-oriented connectivity for both Google and third-party SaaS services that you consume on Google Cloud. It's a method of connecting two cloud networks together without peering and also without sharing IP address space. As an alternative to network peering, it's a seamless way of communicating with services from within GCP or even from on-premise. PSC is fundamentally a service-oriented concept. So it provides you with private IP addresses from inside your VPC, and you can use those to connect to services. And so you can use it to privately access Google services like GCS or BigQuery or Spanner. You can also use it for third-party SaaS services, such as MongoDB or Snowflake or DataStax. It can also be used for your own services itself. So imagine you have multiple services that are across different VPCs for either organizational or security reasons, and you need to punch a hole through from one VPC to another to allow a client to access just that service. So PSC is useful for all these different use cases. And it introduces the concept of consumers, which are the ones who initiate a connection to a service, and the producers, who are the ones who are offering a service to be connected to. On the consumer side here, we're showing VMs running in GCP and also clients connecting to on-prem, and they can both reach a PSC endpoint. And so this is allowing client traffic traverse to manage services privately. And so in the managed services that are running in different VPCs, that is not seen by the clients. All they see is the PSC endpoints itself. And so this is nice for security reasons and segmentation reasons. Also, you don't need to go through the public internet or anything like that to reach other VPCs. And it also cuts down on the shared dependencies between consumers and producers. At the end of the day, you get a simple and scalable way to connect to services, no matter what those services actually are. And so this shows the difference between VPC peering and Private Service Connect, where VPC peering is the concept of taking two VPCs and connecting them together so that they have open and shared IP space between them. And so this is a very permissive and open model of connecting networks that is great for a variety of use cases. However, when using services, you might not need all that level of access. And so Private Service Connect allows a single endpoint to be connected to from a producer VPC. And so all of the VMs or IP addresses inside that producer VPC are not directly addressable from the consumer. And so this is a much more explicit and fine-tuned access model for producers to explicitly allow certain consumers to connect to them. And so it really protects both sides and is kind of a more scalable model for both consumers and producers. At the end of the day, you get many-to-one connectivity rather than many-to-many connectivity. And so now you have fewer shared constraints between consumers and producers because it's not the same peered network, and also no IP coordination required because you have NATing going on so that there is no shared IP space between consumers and producers. PSC is also deeply integrated with the Google Cloud load balancers that we have. There's two major varieties. One is Private Service Connect, or also known as L4 PSC, in which there is a PSC endpoint inside the consumer VPC that can be directly addressed by a VM or something else running inside the VPC. And so this allows clients to go directly to that endpoint, and that endpoint is mapped to a load balancer on the producer side, which has the service backends behind it. There's also PSC with consumer access or consumer service controls, or L7 PSC. So this is very similar, but instead this PSC endpoint is actually a backend to an HTTPS cloud load balancer. And so this gives a lot more control of traffic or certificates that might want to be placed in front of a managed service. It gives the consumer this control to use all the capabilities of a load balancer. If you want to put your own domain or certificate in front of the managed service, well, that's fine. You can do that because you have that control. Or you can control failover policies between managed services if that's not something that the managed service does itself. And so this level of control is deeply integrated with our cloud load balancers. And before I go any further, I want to introduce Chris Shum from MongoDB, who can talk to us about how they integrated on top of PSC to provide seamless service connectivity to their consumers.
Thank you, Mark. My name is Chris Shum, and I'm the lead product manager for MongoDB Atlas. I'm excited to be able to spend a couple of minutes today talking about how we've been able to integrate with Google Private Service Connect. MongoDB provides companies with the industry's first application data platform that allows developers to move fast and simplify how they build with data for any application. With a platform that offers built-in capabilities for multiple critical workloads within an organization, like operational workloads, search, real-time analytics, and even mobile use cases, our platform allows organizations to forget about rationalizing their data infrastructure and instead spend time on what matters: innovation and unique differentiation. We offer one of the most advanced cloud database services on the market, with unmatched data distribution and mobility across 95 regions globally on all three hyperscale cloud providers, including almost 30 regions on Google Cloud. And we've been fortunate to have Google as a strategic partner throughout the years. As a data platform, we are custodians of our customers' data, so security is always top of mind for us. We know that security is first and foremost for any modern application, and we believe in a security by default posture. And we have relentlessly invested in best-in-class security controls to enable our customers to rest easy at night knowing their data is secure. So you can imagine our excitement when Google released Private Service Connect. So much so that we in fact became a launch partner when Google made PSC generally available 9 months ago. Private Service Connect allows customers to connect their applications running in their Google environments seamlessly and securely to their databases running in MongoDB Atlas, using the L4 PSC option that Mark was describing. And in doing so, PSC offers a few very nice qualities out of the box. Number one, one-way connection. As Mark mentioned, connections via PSC must be initiated by the consumer. This directionality makes the service boundary much more explicit so that there's no extension of the perceived network trust boundary. Number two, PSC offers consolidated security controls across Google Cloud applications and third-party environments, which allows customers to always feel in control of how their data transits from point A to point B. Last but not least, PSC enables transitive connectivity from an on-prem data center to MongoDB Atlas via cloud VPNs, so customers no longer have to worry about exchanging routes or punching holes through firewalls. What I've loved about our integration with PSC the most is that it further enforces MongoDB Atlas as an enterprise-ready solution and as a first-class offering on the Google Cloud platform, similar to other Google Cloud native products. We've been able to see firsthand over the last 9 months exciting adoption of PSC from cloud native startups to tier one investment banks to some of the largest manufacturers in the world. We're excited to see what else is in store, both for PSC and for the partnership between Google and MongoDB.
Thanks, Chris. We're very excited as well. And it really has been a great experience working with MongoDB since the beginning. MongoDB and also many other partners have really taught us a lot. And I think that it's been very powerful for our customers to have such a deep and native integration with third-party SaaS companies. And so I do kind of want to understand what kind of end customer friction points existed, or what kinds of things were customers asking for before you integrated on top of PSC?
Great question. As recently as a year ago, I'd say the conversation around data transfer was between public and private networking. We had IP access lists for public networking, and for those customers who preferred private networking, we had VPC peering. Even though VPC peering itself allowed all data transfers to go across private networks, we heard from customers that it wasn't sufficient, primarily because of InfoSec requirements or concerns around directionality and transitivity that you talked about. And often that meant that we had to develop workarounds on a case-by-case basis, something white glove that worked for each customer's unique environment, and that was so time-consuming. With PSC, we've repositioned the entire conversation. Customers understand that PSC is the best-in-class native option for highly secure one-way private connectivity. And what that means is we no longer spend time in the pre-sale cycle going back and forth with the customer on their security model and the challenges that come with different access methods. For customers, it brings peace of mind that the partner they've chosen really understands their security requirements and they feel secure in trusting their data to us.
Yeah, I think that's so important. And you mentioned the security teams, which is such a big kind of aspect of onboarding new services or anything new in kind of in an IT organization. How has PSC impacted your sales cycle, or to put it another way, you know, how has it impacted the pace of adoption for MongoDB?
With PSC, the time we spend during sales cycles talking about networking has definitely reduced. And although networking is a pretty fascinating topic, I'm pretty happy to be able to spend less time talking about it. And instead, we can spend more time talking about what MongoDB Atlas as a platform can do for our customers, which is fantastic.
Yeah, I completely agree. I think that, you know, as much as I love talking about networking, not spending all the time on networking and spending more time on what's unique to your product and your service is definitely where you want to spend your time. Chris and I were actually working with a large manufacturing customer that kind of showed the power of PSC. We saw the relationship between database teams and networking teams at play, where we had database teams that were wanting to spin up MongoDB clusters, and they're kind of the requesters of it, or the application teams are. And with PSC, it made it a lot easier to templatize their deployment of MongoDB. And so it could be stamped out. And so the friction between the security team, which had to kind of authorize or maybe look over peering relationships, which with a much closer eye, really reduced the amount of time it took to spin these things up. And so we saw kind of the service adoption and service deployment really go up because we've reduced the friction. And we saw an interesting trend where once a company had kind of validated a service on PSC for the first time, it became very reusable for other services as well. And so once you go through the first one, your security team and networking teams kind of understand the model, but this model is also applicable to other kinds of services across, you know, for multiple instances of MongoDB, but also for other entirely different services. Is the security model and everything's like that very similar? And so you don't have these kind of custom one-off integration points between managed services and the customer's cloud network. And I think that's really powerful in making service consumption seamless. And then also to some degree, giving some control back to the network and security teams because it all feels a bit more policy oriented, all feels a little bit more centralized and visible and all the things that they want to have when they have, you know, managing large networks and large organizations. So I think that's been some really amazing trends that we've seen with PSC. Moving over to kind of your perspective, could you describe your process of bringing Atlas to GA on PSC with GCP?
Yeah. I'd say we were very fortunate to have been invited into the design process very early on. I remember talking about PSC more than 2 years ago when it was still just an idea. And so I'd say for being at, and I think the first version of PSC that we integrated would probably be best described as a pre-alpha product. And for being a pre-alpha product where the first version of instructions that we received was quite literally just a Google Docs, it was a surprisingly smooth integration. With any pre-alpha product, we expected to have a couple of kinks that we had to work through. But fortunately, I think Google really leaned in to make sure we were successful. And I hope that we've now paved the way for many other partners to successfully integrate with PSC as well. Now that we're seeing it on the other side and have customers creating private endpoints in their environments, we've been incredibly pleased with how well the integration is working.
And then how has integrating with PSC changed how you go to market to your customers with Google Cloud?
I'd say that PSC has enabled Google and MongoDB to go to market and co-sell in a way that I never thought was possible. I've personally been in multiple conversations with customers where both the field and R&D teams from Google and MongoDB were present, which is frankly pretty unheard of prior to PSC. And on the one hand, I think this is a testament to the strategic partnership between Google and MongoDB and how much we're investing into co-selling together. But on the other hand, I think this also goes to show how PSC makes MongoDB feel like a first-class offering on the platform as if Google was hosting it itself. And it's been such a joy working with the Google team so closely over the last 12 plus months, and I'm excited for what else is in store.
Yeah, so am I. And I think you hit the right point, which is really about that first-class, you know, native integration with GCP. And for customers of Google Cloud that are using services, this consistency is really important because, again, like we mentioned before, it makes it provides you a single model for how you manage services, no matter what that service is. And I think that networking teams and security teams are really going to like that. And it's going to speed up adoption within their companies. Well, Chris, thank you so much for coming on. It's been a pleasure working with you and the entire MongoDB team. Once again, I'm also very excited for what we have in store.
Thanks for having me.